Now, let's look at convex lens. There are two types of convex lens. The first one is cylindrical convex lens. The other type is spherical convex lens. For a convex lens, the middle part of the lens is thicker than that of the edge. And this type of lens we call biconvex lens. We have another type of convex lens that we call Penglo convex lens. What happens when two parallel light waves pass through a convex lens? When the light waves pass through the surface AB, since it travels from air to glass, by law of refraction, the light wave will bend towards the normal. When it hits the surface CD, the light wave will reflect from glass to air. Hence, it will reflect towards or away from normal. The answer is it reflects away from normal. Similarly, for another light wave travels at the bottom, due to reflection, it will bend towards the normal. At the surface CD, this light wave will reflect away from normal. Hence, the two parallel light waves will reflect in the directions as shown. That means the light wave will converge. Therefore, convex lens is also called converging lens. When three parallel light waves parallel to the principal axis towards the lens, after reflections, the light wave will converge at a point which we call focus. The distance between the focus and the lens is called focal length. Notice that the light wave traveling and pass through the center of the lens will travel in a straight line. For a convex lens, there are two focus equal distance from the center of the lens C. The distance between F and C is the focal length F. The plane passing through the focus and perpendicular to the principal axis is called focal plane. Parallel light waves passing through the convex lens will converge at a point on the focal plane. The focal length of a convex lens depends on its thickness. In diagram 1, for parallel light waves passing through the convex lens, the light wave will converge at the point we call focus with focal length F. For a thicker convex lens, the parallel light waves traveling parallel to the principal axis will converge at a point which is nearer to the lens than before. Therefore, a thicker lens has shorter focal length. There are three special light ways for a convex lens. First, when the light ray travels in a direction parallel to the principal axis, it will reflect passing through the focus on the other side. Secondly, when the light ray traveling in a direction passing through the center of the lens, it will travel along the same line. The third special light ray is that for the light ray passing through the focus, it will reflect in a direction parallel to the principal axis. Let's see the methods to find the image formed by a convex lens. The first method is by using ray diagrams. First, let's see when the object is put in front of focus. That means the object distance U is smaller than the focal length F. By using special light waves, we send the first light wave parallel to the principal axis and pass through the focus. The second light wave pass through the center of the lens. These two light waves, when produced backward, will meet at the point which is the image position. Next, we use an arrow to show the image eye. The result shows that the image is virtual, erect, and magnified. Also, the image and the objects are at the same size of the lens. If the object is of the letter P, then the image when looking through the lens will be magnified and erect. The lens used in this case is as a magnifying glass. Next, let's see what happens when the object is put between F and 2F. That is, the object distance U lies between F and 2F. Again, we use two special light waves. And we used an arrow to draw the image. In this case, the image is well inverted and magnified, and the image is at the opposite side as the object. If the object is seen through the lens, if the object is letter P, then the image would be the image is inverted and magnified. The third case is that the object is put at 2F. That is, object distance U equal to 2F. By using lightweight, parallel to the principal axis, and passing through the center, we find that the image will be at 2F at the other side, and the image nature is, it is wheel, inverted, and same size. Also, it is at opposite side as the object. That is, if the object is letter P, then the image scene would be D, which is of the same size. In case 4, the object is put behind 2F, that is, U is longer than 2F. By using special lightweights, we find that the image is between F and 2F on the other side. And the image is wheel, inverted, but diminished. Also, the image is at the opposite side as the object. If the object is letter P, then as seen through the lens, the image will be smaller letter D. This has a revision on the image formed by convex lens. For case 1, if U is smaller than F, then the image must be virtual, erect, and at the same size as the object. Virtual, erect, and same size should be used together. Second, the third and the fourth case, when the object is at different positions with different value of U, we have wheel, inverted, and opposite side image. These three words, wheel, inverted, and opposite side, are using together. When U lies between F and 2F, the image distance is longer than 2F, therefore we have magnified image. When U equal to 2F, we have V equal to 2F. In this case, magnification equal to 1, therefore we have same size of image. When U is larger than 2F, we have V lies between F and 2F. In this case, the image is diminished. The light waves sent from A, 1, 2, 3, two of them are special light wave. For wave 2, it is parallel to the principal axis, therefore, it reflects and passes through the focus. For wave 3, it passes through the center of the lens in a straight line. By producing these two light waves backward, they will meet at the point which is the image of A. We call it A. Therefore, wave 1 can be drawn by connecting A pi to the point. Next, wave 4 is sent out from B. After reflection, wave 4 should produce backward and meet the image B pi. Therefore, we can draw the reflected wave 4 accurately. Example 2, For the first diagram, since the object distance u is longer than 2f, therefore the image I should have the following image nature, which is wheel, invert, and diminished. Also, the image will be within f and 2f. Hence, we can draw the image for the second case. Now, the object's distance is larger than focal length f, but smaller than 2f. In this case, the image would be wheel inverted and magnified, and also image distance is larger than 2f. Hence, the image can be drawn . Let's compare real image and virtual image. First, real image can be formed only by using convex lens, while virtual image can be formed by convex lens or concave lens. Second, real image must be inverted, while virtual image must be erect. Next, real image can be magnified, same size, or diminished. And virtual image can be magnified by using convex lens and diminished by using concave lens, and also can be same size by using perimeter. Next, real image and virtual image both can be seen by the eyes. However, only real image can be captured or can be formed on the screen, while virtual image cannot be formed on the screen. Let's see how to capture a far object. When an object is at a long distance, or we say a far object is away from a convex lens, the light from the tip of the object when traveling towards the lens, the light waves appears to be parallel. By using a wave diagram, the parallel light waves will converge at the focal plane. Therefore, an inverted image will be shown if a screen is put on the focal plane. By using this method, we can find the focal length of the convex lens, which is equal to the distance between the image on the screen and the lens. Example 3. Part A. We should use convex lens because convex lens can converge the light wave . Part B. For the diagram, we have a convex lens. The parallel light waves from the sun towards the lens will converge at the focus. And the paper is put at the regions near the focus of the lens. Therefore, the paper will be heat to a high temperature and then burned. Since the distance between the lens and the paper is equal to the focal length, therefore, the focal length of the lens is equal to 5 cm. Example 4. Part A, the image ledger is magnified and erect. Part B, the lens should be convex. The reason is that only convex lens can produce erect and magnifying image. Part C. This is a magnifying glass. Therefore, the wave diagram is the object is in front of the focus. Therefore, we have an erect image and magnifying image. Example 5, Part A. The image ledger, it is diminished and erect. For Part B, this is concave lens because only concave lens produce diminished and erect image. Part C, the wave diagram is this one. By drawing special light waves, we find that the image is in front of the lens and lies between focus and the lens. For example 6, the image ledgers when looking through the glass of water is that the image is diminished and inverted. The lens we are using for Part B is that we are using convex lens because only convex lens will produce diminished and inverted image. For part C, in order to produce a real diminished and inverted image, the objects should be put behind 2F. And the image lies between F and 2F on the other side. Example 7, part A, the image ledger is erect and diminished. Part B, he is using a concave lens. The reason is that only concave lens can produce erect and diminished image. For part C, we can draw a Venn diagram to illustrate how the image is formed. When the object is in front of the concave lens, use special light waves. We find that the image is formed in front of the lens. Let's see another method to study image form by convex lens. Now we use lens formula 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V to study the image formed by convex lens. When using the lens formula for a convex lens, the focus is real focus. Therefore, we substitute positive value for the focal length F. Since the object is real, therefore, we substitute positive value for the object distance, U. If the image frame is real, then the values of V would be positive. That means positive value of V implies that the image is real. If the value of V is negative, that means we have virtual image. Example 8. The distance x is equal to the object distance u. Image distance is v. The focal length is 20 cm. By using the lens formula, we have 1 over f equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. For a convex lens, f is equal to 20 cm. Therefore, we have 1 over 20 equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. When u is 10, 1 over 20 equal to 1 over 10 plus 1 over v. 1 over v equal to 1 over 20 minus 1 over 10 equal to negative 1 over 20. Therefore, V equal to negative 20. The negative sign means that the image is virtual and the image distance is equal to 20 cm. When x changes to 30 cm, we have U equal to 30 cm. Then we have 1 over 20 equal to 1 over 30 plus 1 over V. Therefore, we have 1 over V equal to 1 over 20 minus 1 over 30, which is equal to 1 over 60. and V equal to 60 cm. It is positive, means that the image is real, and the image distance V is 60 cm. When U equal to 40 cm, again we have 1 over 20 equal to 1 over 40 plus 1 over V. Therefore, 1 over V equal to 1 over 20 minus 1 over 40. In this case, we have 1 over V equal to 1 over 40. Hence, V equal to 40. Again, it is positive, which means the image is real, and the image distance is 40 cm. When x changed to 60 cm, which means u equal to 60, we have 1 over 20 equal to 1 over 60 plus 1 over v. Therefore, 1 over v equal to 1 over 20 minus 1 over 60, which is equal to 1 over 30. Hence, V equal to 30 cm. It is positive, means the image is again real, and the image distance is equal to 30 cm. Example 9. Since the image is erect, which means that it is a virtual image, the lens formula 1 over f equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. U is equal to the object distance, which is 25. Since it is virtual image, the image distance 50 cm, when substitutes into v, we got negative value. Therefore, we have v equal to negative 50. Therefore, we have 1 over f equal to 1 over 50, implying focal length equal to 50 cm. Example 10. Since the image is magnified and inverted, an inverted image, which means that the image is real, the lens formula 1 over f equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. The object distance u is 25 cm. Since the image is real, therefore we substitute 50 cm into v. Therefore, we have 1 over f equal to 3 over 50, implying that the focal length of the lens is 50 over 3, or equal to 16.7 cm. Example 11. The lens formula 1 over f equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. The object distance is 20 cm, therefore we have u equal to 20 cm. Since this is a concave lens of focal length 10 cm, for a concave lens, we have virtual focus, which means that f equal to negative 10. Therefore, we have v equal to negative 6.67 cm. The negative sign means that the image is virtual, and the image distance is equal to 6.67 cm. Example 12. By lens formula, 1 over f equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. The object distance is 20 cm, which means u equal to 20 cm. Since it's a convex lens, which has wheel focus. Therefore, we substitute the focal length 10 cm, which is 10 into F. By solving the equation, we got V equal to 20 cm. It is positive, which means the image is wheel, and the image distance is equal to 20 cm. Example 13, part A. A1. By using Lenz formula, 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V. The object distance is 30 cm. We have U equal to 30. Since it's a convex lens, the focal length 10 cm. Therefore, F equal to 10. By solving this equation, 1 over V equal to 1 over 10 minus 1 over 30, we got V equal to 15 cm. Therefore, we have Y equal to 15 cm. Part 2, the magnification M equal to V over U equal to 15 over 30 equal to 0.5, which is smaller than 1, which means that the image is diminished. Part B, since the image is wheel and diminished, inverted, therefore we have the image shown on the screen. For a convex lens, the lens formula 1 over V plus 1 over U equal to 1 over F. When the image form is wheel, that is when the object distance is larger than the focal length, we have two special graphs for convex lens. The first is the graph of V image distance against U object distance. It would be this one. At the point P, with U equal to 2F and V equal to 2F, we have magnification equal to 1. When the object distance increases from 2F, we see that U increases while V decreases. Since M equal to V over U, which means that the magnification will decrease. However, when U decreases, we have V increases. That means the magnification will be larger than 1. This happens when U is smaller than 2F but larger than F. Another graph which is very important is the graph of 1 over V against 1 over U. From the lens formula, we will see that the graph of 1 over V against 1 over U would be a straight line with both the x-intercept and the y-intercept equal to 1 over F. Therefore, we can use the intercept to find the focal length of the lens. Example 14, part A. When the object distance is equal to 2F, we have image distance equal to 2F. Therefore, from the graph, we see that 2F equal to 25. Which means that the focal length of the convex lens equal to 12.5 cm. Part B. If initially the object is put between F and 2F, which means that the object distance lies between F and 2F. In this case, the image will be magnified and the image distance V will be larger than 2F. This means that V is larger than U. Let's mark a point on the graph for V larger than U. Now, when the object is moved away from the lens, that means U increases. From the graph, we see that when U increases, V will decrease. That means the magnification equal to V over U would be decreases. Example 15, part A. By lens formula 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V, we have learned that the intercept on the graph is equal to 1 over F. Therefore, we have 1 over F equal to 0.05 and F equal to 20 cm. Therefore, the focal length of the convex lens equal to 20 cm. For part B, if a thicker convex lens is used, which means that the focal length of the lens will decrease. Therefore, the focal length of the thicker convex lens would be smaller than 20 cm. Hence, 1 over f will be larger than 0.05. The real graph would be like this one. Example 16. From the figure, we see that the object distance equal to 30 cm and the image distance equal to 20 cm. Therefore, magnification equal to V over U equal to 20 over 30, which is 0.667. For part B, since the image can be formed on the screen, therefore, the image nature must be wheel and inverted. Also, because magnification is smaller than 1, therefore, the image will be diminished. The image shown on the screen would be a smaller letter D. Part C, by lens formula, 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V equal to 1 over 30 plus 1 over 20, implying that the focal length of the lens equal to 12 cm. Example 17. The lens used is convex. Because only convex lens can form an image on the screen. For part B, applying lens formula, we have the object distance U equal to 40. Since the image is wheel, therefore the image distance 60 cm means that V equal to 60. Therefore, we have the focal length of the convex lens equal to 24 cm. Now we have U equal to 40 cm and V equal to 60 cm. By reversibility of light waves, if we change U to 60 cm and V equal to 40 cm, then we have another sharp image formed on the screen. Therefore, we have to move the lens towards the screen 20 cm. In order to change the image distance from 60 cm to 40 cm, and to change the object distance from 40 cm to 60 cm. Example 18. The magnification equal to V over U equal to 60 over 20 equal to 3. Part B. Since the sharp image formed on the screen, it must be wheel and inverted. Since it is also magnified, therefore, we have the letter shown on the screen. Part C. By using lens formula, 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V. Since the image is wheel, we have V equal to 60 and U is 20. Therefore, we have the focal length of the convex lens equal to 15 cm. Part D. Image formed by concave lens can never be captured by a screen. The reason is that all the image formed by concave lens are virtual, and virtual image cannot form on a screen.